Bootleg TV, music, fun, entertainment, you, me, nothing can go wrong. Let's do it!
Hi, I'm Jim Jackson. Come on in. Check out some art. I paint pictures, pictorials, and I kind of like to render things a little more realistic because of my commercial art background. I like to render things a little more realistic, but I'm trying to chop that up. I really like impressionism, but I'd say I'm just a painter, you know, I just paint. Just a painter. I try not to pin myself down to anything in particular because then I don't want to get into like a deal where I'm just like painting the same type stuff over and over again, which is what I've done in my commercial art, which is what I don't want to do in my fine art. So I paint like a lot of different stuff, and if you look around the gallery, you'll see many different examples of the different kinds of things I like to paint, from realism to abstract to impressionistic, you know, all kinds of cool stuff, just like raw underpaintings and stuff. I started basically drawing on school desks when I was in the first grade. That's when I realized that, you know, I just like doing that. And I got in a lot of trouble for it, but that didn't stop me. Like 16, 17, I sort of realized what I was going to do with my life. I knew then that's what I wanted to do, but I had to have, of course, make a living, so I had like other jobs and stuff. And work like manual labor like everybody else does. And did a bunch of, just started doing, then I started taking little odd jobs on, painting signs and just little things like that, trying to work with other artists. I'd learn from people, other artists, good and bad. You know, I met some artists that would turn me away because they felt threatened, you know, they didn't want to share the knowledge that they had learned. Because maybe I'm a threat if I learned it, you know what I mean? But then I'd find other cats that would lay it on me lovingly because I asked. And those were the cats, of course, I was supposed to meet and learn from. What helped shape and mold me into the guy I am today was those people that I learned from. Beautiful souls that weren't bashful about sharing the knowledge, you know, and giving somebody a hand up. You know? My mama really raised me up with a love of, like, music, and I love music and rock and roll, and I got to learn there's a reason why these people are so loved by people, and it's because they speak a certain universal truth through their music. Well, out of respect for the talent that the good Lord has given me, I'm going to try to achieve the highest understanding I can of painting, and therefore being the best that I could possibly be at it, and that's what my goal is. Well, I mean, I really like Van Gogh. I know it sounds like a stereotypical answer. I like Monet. I like... You know, I like, you know, of course I like Dali, but I don't try to copy any one of their styles, but try to put them all together and create my own style. But, let's see, who's another one? Vermeer is a really good realistic painter that I really enjoy. Even back then, he's the man, you know. I mean, I could never possibly dream of being as good as him. That's why I try to, I got a couple books on, I try to study what he was about so I could learn, you know. I mean, it's painting, to paint that good, you got to be tapped into some energy that I hope to one day be tapped into. You know you love it. I was waiting at a bus stop, and for the bus, because I didn't have a car or nothing, you know. And here comes this bus in front of me. And I'm like, this thing's got a paint job on it. It was painted. I could see it was. And I've never seen anything like it. It was pretty cool. So I immediately realized that this, whoever painted that, knew what they were doing. And I didn't know nothing compared to whoever painted that bus. And I wanted to meet the guy. So I pursued it. do that. I walked in there and pursued this guy, Doug Budworth, who was painting at us. But he realized quickly I didn't know nothing like he did. And so the roles were established quickly that I was his apprentice. You know? And that took a few times of going back and showing my persistent effort and really wanting. I was hungry, you know. Man, show me something. Teach me. I really like me. I'm one of the funnest people I've ever met. Guys, thanks for stopping by the Jim Jackson Gallery, man. Local art, come on in and check it out.